Okay, today we're going to share another multiplication strategy. I found this online from a guy named Dave Hax, so I want to give him credit. It's not something that I invented or created. So we're going to show a little trick, okay? And this could really be used when you're double checking an answer, okay? So the number 21, we're going to represent it like this. Okay, bear with me if you think that this is something out of the ordinary. Just please be patient. Okay. Now, do you guys see how this represents 21? Yeah. You have a 2 and a 1. And let's do 13 like this. Something like this. Roll. Okay, so now the key here is to look at the numbers in a vertical way. So I actually, the way I drew it, I actually have to twist my paper a little bit. Because you guys know I'm not really good at drawing lines, even with a ruler. Okay, so now the little trick is counting the dots, or the intersecting lines like we learned in geometry. Start over here on the far right. 1, 2, 3. You put a 3 there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You put the 7 here. 1, 2. You put the 2 there. So now the 3 numbers that you have written down are your answer. So now if you want to confirm this, I'll just prove it to you. You go into your calculator, 21 multiplied by 13 equals 273, okay? So that's one example. Let's do another example. We have, you do a bigger number if you want. Let's involve one with a little carrying, okay? So let's try this. Let's go 35 multiplied by 13. Why not? 13 is a good number. For some people, at least, right? Unless it's a Friday. You guys know what I'm talking about. Black cats and Friday the 13th. Here, so let's do this. 1, 2. So now I'm going to draw 5 lines down here. Okay, and then the 13 be like this. Okay. So remember, you have to line them up vertically. If you have to twist your page like I do, because I'm terrible at the lines, do this. You do that. And you do that. So let's count the intersecting lines once again. Put like a little circle around them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Well, it poses a little problem now because we're in double digits. So if you put the 5 here, and just put a little plus 1 at the top here. Count the lines here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh, no, my pen broke. 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Since we have 14, the number of interest for us is the number 4. So 4 plus 1 becomes 5, and then you do another plus 1 here. Then you have 1, 2, 3. So 3 plus 1 is 4. So now we have 4, a 5, and a 5. 455. And to confirm it, 35 multiplied by 13 is 455. Okay? But of course, this stuff's too easy for us. Yes, Ali.
My question is that, over here, it's like three circles, right? You know how like there's three of them?
Yes.
So does it always have to be three, or there can be more?
I was actually going to get to one right now. That's a great question. Great segue, by the way. Going to our next question. 321 multiplied by 13. Actually, 13, I'm sick of it now. Pick a different number.
15.
Let's do 14. 15. You want to do 20?
21.
Let's do 20. Let's do 23. Okay, something that is completely new to me. I've never done this example. But now that we have a extra column here, the hundreds column is now being used, this is what we can do. So follow this carefully. So the 3 can still be represented like this. So now we don't have a bottom value. We do have a middle number, which is the 2. In this case, the 2 represents the tens column. Draw two lines here. And then now we have the ones column. We can key it to the bottom. So now it's just a little bit larger. The 23 could be represented like this. And then the 3 will be closer to here. So now let me address your question. What's it going to look like? Well, again, this is very tricky for me because I cannot draw straight lines. But if I twist my page, the trick becomes, you know, much easier, less of a trick, let's say. Okay, so let's get a different color here to make it. Okay, so now we count the intersecting lines here. That's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So what should I write at the top here if it's 13? What should I write?
Plus 3.
3, yes. And then you do the plus 1 over here. Yeah. Right? Not over here, not over here, over here. That's why we're going in this direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 plus 1 will give us 7. We can cross that out now. So now, I have recorded 7383, which is 7,383. Put this in the calculator. 321 multiplied by 23, 7383, or 7,383. Yes, Aaliyah?
What happens if the first column is on the left, comes to double digit number?
So if this becomes a double-digit number, great answer. Great question, by the way. So if just say this was 9 here. If it's 9 plus 1, you keep it 10. As long as this column here, the last one, the furthest left, is allowed to have double digits. It's the last person. That's where all the leftovers eventually end up. This one, no room for leftovers. Picture these three living in like a small house. There's not much room here, there's not much room here, there's not much room here. This one's the mansion or the castle, okay? It fits more stuff. So it doesn't matter how many you have, the far left one will always fit more. Picture it like the big house on the block. Yes, Isa?
I have another question. For the second number, what if it's like a 1? Would you just do it on the left side?
So if this one here?
No, if the, like,
if it's just one number, then you probably can just do it the 1. I think this is more effective with double digits and triple digits. Okay, that's a good question. I haven't tried that, and I'm probably going to edit that out because I don't have an answer for it.
Can you do that with decimals?
If you can do this with decimals, I won't edit that out because it's a good question and I didn't have the answer. So I don't have a problem admitting that I don't know something. You can theoretically do this with decimals. If this was 32.1 multiplied by 2.3, this works. Okay? You just have to count how many decimals you used here. One, two. So then you would put your answer would be 3073.83. And to confirm that, 32.1 multiplied by 2.3, 73.83. Remember, the trick with decimals is when you're multiplying, how many spaces come after the decimals? So if this was 3.21 multiplied by 2.3, your answer is 7.383. And let's confirm that so you don't think I'm lying to you, because nobody likes a liar. 7.383. If this number was recorded as decimal 3.21 multiplied by 2.3, we have four decimal places. 1, 2, 3, 4. Same numbers are being multiplied, so it would be decimal 7.383. And let's confirm that. Decimal 3.21 multiplied by 2.3. Okay, and then they put the zero here. And lastly, let's do one more. Pretend this was decimal 3.21 multiplied by decimal 23. How many decimal places do we have now being used? How many are in play now? There are five. Problem is there are only four digits in our answer, which we know is this is our answer. Add an extra digit here and put a decimal. And to confirm that, decimal 3.21 multiplied by 0.23, there's your answer right there. Okay? So for any form of multiplying, when the decimals come into play, just remember the trick. You got to put them where they need to go. Virg. What about ratios? Can you do this with ratios? Is that your question? No, you definitely can't. You're right. Yeah, this has nothing to do with ratios. You could find a way to apply it, just not. And this lesson is just for straight multiplying.
For the decimal, can you just like, first take them away, then do the multiplying, and just put
one of the best ideas I've ever heard. When there are decimals there, take them away. Do your regular multiplying and put them back at the end. Just don't forget you took them away. Take them away and you don't put them back, your answer is always going to be wrong. The digits will be the same, but the value will be wrong. Okay?
For that one, 321,
yep.
How's your five?
Yeah. Right here. Let's count them out, okay? I'll use a pencil here. So here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So then, the little trick that my teacher used to teach me back in the day was write the answer down like this. Start here and do little loops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you put the decimal there. And because we have like a little loop or a cup, whatever she called it, I don't even remember. It's been so long. Early 90s.
Mr. Ford, please call room 204. Mr. Ford, 204. Thank you.
She told me to put the zero there and a zero there because there is always a zero in front if there's nothing there. It just looks better. From what I was told, I bought into it. I do it.